Hi, Sai, everybody. I thought I would reintroduce all of you to my portable makiwara here. I'll be using it in this next demonstration as a focusing post for, I would say, not a lesson on how to punch, but a lesson on how to improve your punches. So let's give it a go. When throwing a straight punch, you want to keep your fist and your shoulder in the same line. It's okay to have your elbow out just a little bit. I see a lot of, when I am at kickboxing classes at the gym, you know, it's more of an aerobic class, it's not a martial art class. I see a lot of people swinging their arms like this to do their punches or their jabs, which isn't good form. It's actually, it can cause problems later on. The idea here is you want to keep your shoulder and your fist in the same line while it's traveling. Okay, you can throw a vertical punch, okay, or a corkscrew punch. Really doesn't matter. But the idea here is to keep the shoulder and the fist in the same line. Okay, if you can keep your elbow down, okay, that helps disguise your technique. Okay, if you tend to have your elbow, what we call chicken wing, if you chicken wing it, okay, it's easier for your opponent to see that coming. Okay, so if you keep your elbow down, okay, you can twist the last moment, that's when your elbow will pop out a little bit, okay, like so. Okay, so it's important when we are doing a straight jab that you put your entire body behind the strike. Okay, don't just reach out with your fist. Okay, I mean, it doesn't take a lot to hurt someone just by reaching out. I mean, a little baby can poke your eyes out. Okay, but if you're looking for some power behind the punch, you need to use your entire body. And the way you do that is you start at the bottom. Okay, pivot your rear foot, turn your hips, point with your shoulder, and then extend with your fist. Okay, it looks like this. So. Do the other side here, okay, from here. Point to shoulder, extend the arm, okay. So it all happens in one motion. Now let's talk about collapsing technique. Collapsing technique is multiple strikes, I like to say in one breath, okay. So a combination would be one, okay, two, and then three. Okay, a collapsing technique, it's one count. So jab, palm heel, elbow strike. It happens in one motion. Okay. All right, so I'm going to demonstrate that collapsing technique again on the other side, different angle. Okay, once again, combination would be one, two, three. Okay, those would be three short breaths. Collapsing technique, I like to do it in one breath. So, and then the other side. Well, I thought some of you might be interested in the construction of my focusing post, aka makiwara. It's portable. As you can see, I can roll this thing around. It's basically just a round plywood base, and there's a metal tube on the inside surrounded by foam insulation, and then I just wrapped it in rope. And then up top here is an oversized tennis ball. You can get these at pet stores. It's a chew toy for a large dog. And you can see down here that I've added, you can see like these little bolts here. When I want to make this base heavier, if I want to do some heavy hitting on it, I can add weight. So that's what these extra bolts here are for. It's for bolting weight to the base so that it doesn't tip over. Some of you may be interested in wondering, what is this thing here? This is a, I would call it a, or describe it as a gimbal. And basically what that does is, if I can get close, low enough, you'll see that there's some springs underneath. And what that allows is for the, if I stand on it here, what it allows is when you strike the post, it allows it to move a little bit. And the reason why I have this is so that it simulates the impact on the human body, basically, supposedly.